Williamson here for Behind the Bars this week, mechanic for Ryan Villapoto.
As far as the engine goes with Ryan, we start out by running a transmission that has, you know, obviously a taller first. I think everybody has for the, you know, out in Supercross. They use first quite a bit coming out of the corners and jumping. So we run a little bit different gear ratio to compensate for the transmission. And as far as power, he likes a lot of power, but he likes it smooth. He doesn't like it to hit real hard to where the thing's, you know, hard to ride. He wants it to be easy to ride for 20 minutes and not throw him off if he grabs a handful, you know. So he's not too picky on the engine side, but I think it's really close even between Supercross and outdoors engine spec wise for him. So it works out good. As far as the gearing goes, is we have it's got enough range on the track for us so that we haven't changed our rear sprocket size in a long time because it's just in that window where he likes the power, so it actually works out really good for us. Suspension wise, it's kind of one of those things where you got to keep up with the speed of Ryan. You know, earlier in the year we were maybe on a little bit of a softer setting coming in, but as every rider does, they pick up speed as they start racing, and you just got to keep up with that, going a little bit stiffer, you know, and compensating for each track. So it's kind of crazy because he used to weigh a lot more, but now that he's even lighter, you know, I think he's weighing in at somewhere around 145 to 150. He's actually on stiffer suspension than he raced 2 years ago when he was 170 or 175. So yeah, it's just kind of keeping up with his speed and as the year goes on and adjusting for each track. When it comes to like Daytona, the mud race, it doesn't matter what you're riding. It's an equalizer. I mean, guys on stock, but you can ride a stock bike, and it's just if you're good in the mud, you're good in the mud. And you know, I've seen a lot of guys that you don't see up front, and I think it's just because they're really good in the mud, you know. And so when it comes to a race like that, I mean, some of the suspension guys will put grease in the front seals or put a tighter spring on the dust seal just to try to keep stuff out, but a track like that where it's sandy, you don't really have to do too much. Ryan's controls, he runs a pretty standard bar. It's a Renthal 998 twin wall, and it's pretty normal for most of these guys, I think, to run that bend for the smaller guys. Arc levers we've used for a while since he's been here, and he has some special blades made for him for his little hands and fingers, and Renthal grips, dual compounds. He's pretty easy about it. He doesn't play with any of that stuff. I just set it, and he just runs it. He's not one of those guys that's going to pull over and practice and adjust his lever for sure. He runs the bump on the seat. It's actually moved forward from last year. Just he kind of uses it as a reference for the start so that he sits in the same spot every single time. He doesn't really notice it when he's riding. It's just, like I said, it's more of a reference to put himself in the right position on the start. A lot of our parts too, we make in-house. Like we make our own tie foot pegs at Cowie and KMC, our own triple clamps, linkages, all the little billet stuff. We started bringing that all in-house, chain guides. So it's pretty cool. That's a look at Ryan Villapoto's bike. Hope you enjoyed it.